Throughout the history, Africa has rightly or wrongly been presented as a continent of conflict. This dominant representation of media is limited to this profiling without exploring its historical root cause. According to Albert Legault, in Introduction, Le Conflit du Monde, which was published in 1992, Africa was the scene of more than half of armed conflict taking place in the world at the beginning of this century. When conflict comes, the most serious violation of human rights come with it. Is it not the very history of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights the result of armed conflict resulting from the two most deadly world wars that the world has ever known without Africa being involved in any way in the conception or the benefit of the war? Yet, the African continent did participate passively by contributing to the war effort, of which he didn't know the in and out. As a proof, the Democratic Republic of the Congo, then a colony of the Kingdom of Belgium, was the source of the more deadly mineral, namely uranium, ever used as a weapon of war by the human species against its fellow man, which violated the most fundamental human rights. To this day, the Congo is still the theater of conflict over mineral like coltan. The coltan is a mineral that is used in your cell phone. Each cell phone and all these electronics that we have the coltan that is used. And this coltan is exploited as a result of armed conflict, supported by people from outside, staking outside. And why is Africa still, the continent still presented the one that break record in violation of human rights with several of its leaders and warlords having been convicted on the international tribunal, like the International Criminal Court in The Hague? Is it not because Africa itself was the scene of the most serious human rights violation, like the one in Congo with King Leopold II? Is it not because it was associated with the drafting? It was not associated in the drafting of the Universal Declaration of the Human Rights, drawn in 1948, after the Second World War, that Africa as a whole failed to internalize the concept itself of the declaration. When we know the recent history of African continent, the problem is it currently facing, it is interesting, even indispensable, to question the place occupied by the concept of human rights in such a tormented environment. This will provide an opportunity to investigate the factor that have favored or, on the contrary, delay the emergence of an idea of regional human rights regulation in Africa. This exercise will also enable us later on to assess more precisely the chance of success of such undertaking. For example, probing Africa's traditional past will allow us to confirm or to refute the entrenchment of the concept of human rights in an original environment, and if necessary, to identify the conception of human rights that was enshrined in at the time. This examination will thus help us to better understand the choice made by the drafter of the document that it is subject of this study. Adopted in Nairobi at the AU Assembly, the African Charter of Human Rights and People Rights of 27 June 1981 is an important contribution to the development of African regional law and fill an essential gap in the proclamation of human rights. Although the threshold for entry into force was set very high, ratification by absolute majority of 50 members, the charter entered into force on October 21, 1982. The charter grants top priority attention of the right of people. The reality and the respect of the right of the people must necessarily guarantee human rights. This must be seen as all as the survival of anti-colonialism and the need to fight against the last colonial stronghold. The provision of the charter relating to right of people are also the most complete expression of the modern trend toward collectivization of human rights already mentioned. In this respect, the charter presents the singularity of bringing together apparently antinomic concepts, individual and people, individual right and collective right. Third generation right, classical right, the main interest of the charter lie in the African conception of human rights. According to the African social conception, the individual is enclosed in a dense network of link with his parents, his family, his ethnic group, but also living and the dead, the living and the dead, matter and spirit. The individual is inconceivable as a single being. He exists through the group and is fulfilled in the group, which is at the same time the material condition of his existence, the natural framework of his fulfillment, and finally of his accomplishment. Far from being an antagonist, are dominated by the idea of agreement and harmony. It is probably the sociological and cultural source that the solution to the problem of human rights in Africa will have to be sought. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm.